That's why you can't wear metal in an MRI. Throw a stapler in there, and it's quickly attached to the inner wall. Throw a metal rod in and the suction is so strong, it'll flop around inside. Wheelchairs, vacuum cleaners, oxygen tanks. Any object containing metal that comes near it will be sucked into the MRI. It can diagnose diseases without opening wounds. It's a major advancement in the field of medicine. The MRI is a non-invasive medical device. It is now used in hospitals all over the world. Let's see how it works. Nuclear magnetic resonance is also known as nuclear magnetic resonance imaging technology. It's a system of atomic nuclei in a static magnetic field. When irradiated by electromagnetic waves of a certain frequency, the nucleus resonates with the magnetic field. Through the reception and processing can get the image. Magnetic resonance imaging is now the most commonly used form of imaging. When you hear the word nuclear, it puts people in a state of fear, because the word conjures up images of nuclear radiation. In fact, nuclear refers to the nucleus of hydrogen atoms in the body's tissues. Magnetism is the magnetic field generated by the MRI. It's a powerful force of attraction. That's why you can't wear metal in an MRI. So MRI has nothing to do with ionizing radiation. And there's no radioactivity involved. Nevertheless, the negative connotations of the word nuclear force the name to be changed to magnetic resonance imaging. Using MRI, you can get detailed information about the composition of atoms. As the technology matured, rapidly becoming more widely used in fields such as medicine, biochemistry, physics, and materials science. The use of MRI technology also provides higher accuracy and resolution. NMR works by exciting the nucleus of a hydrogen atom in the body with radio frequency pulses. Because the nucleus is magnetic. Like small magnets, they resonate with hydrogen nuclei of the same frequency in a magnetic field, creating a nuclear spin. The other hydrogen atoms don't resonate, so they change very little. When this radio frequency pulse wears off, these resonating hydrogen atoms will slowly return to their original orientation. This recovery process results in the emission of a signal, and it's picked up by the receiver. The computer processes the images. Hydrogen nuclei from different tissues resonate in a magnetic field. The resonance trajectory is then recorded by an instrument, and then a computer analyzes the data to create the final image. Although the MRI machine generates a very strong magnetic field, but it's not an X-ray. It's not radioactive. It's a non-invasive test. So it's not harmful to the human body. So the question is, can you get an MRI with a steel plate in your body?